One way to think about our solution is this. What if the government cut you a check every month to solve climate change? And what if that led to a solution that was far more effective in reducing emissions? And what if on top of that, everyone from big oil companies to big environmental organizations to opinion leaders from across the political spectrum were getting behind that plan? Well, this is our carbon dividend solution that is promoted by the Climate Leadership Council, and I'm eager to tell you about it. So one of the biggest barriers to climate progress is what I call the psychological barrier. If you think about it, what climate advocates have been encouraging their federal citizens to do is to sacrifice now for benefits that accrue to other people in other countries in 30 or 40 years. And you know what? That just doesn't go over very well because it runs contrary to human nature. And so the way we see solving this problem is to give everyone a concrete benefit in the here and now. Here's how our system would work. It would start with a growing, gradually rising carbon tax, meaning that every time we use a fossil fuel, we would pay a price for its environmental costs. But all of the money, 100%, would go back to the American people in equal monthly dividends. What does that mean? That means a family of four would get about $2,000 per year in dividends. And the Treasury Department found that the bottom 70% of Americans would win under this equation, meaning they would receive more in dividends than they would pay in increased energy prices. That means that 223 million Americans would win from solving climate change. That's one of the key pillars of our plan, and it's the first big barrier to climate progress that we overcome. The second big barrier is the partisan barrier. As we know, the climate issue is overly polarized in the United States. And so what we devised is a plan that starts from a conservative worldview because it is based on the conservative pillars of free markets and limited government. Simply put, we argue for getting the price right and then getting government out of the way. What we mean by that is that we put a carbon tax into effect, give all the money back to the people, and with that, replace existing carbon regulations because our plan would achieve nearly twice the emissions reductions of all Obama-era regulations combined. And our plan by itself would meet the high end of America's commitment under Paris. And the reason I mention these conservative credentials is because the plan started with conservative elder statesmen. So when we first came out with this, our plan was co-authored by James Baker and George Shultz, two of the most respected conservative elder statesmen in America. It was also co-authored by Martin Feldstein and Gregory Mankiw, the two most respected conservative economists in the country. Also co-authors were Henry Paulson and Rob Walton, two of the most respected business leaders. This group of Republican elder statesmen came together as co-authors of what we call a carbon dividends plan. And the reason we call it carbon dividends is because every American would get a monthly dividend. Third major block or barrier to climate progress is what we call the geopolitical barrier. Simply put, under the current rules of global trade, countries have an incentive to free ride off the emissions reductions of other nations instead of strengthening their own programs. In fact, this is one of the things that President Trump talked about when he unfortunately canceled the Paris Climate Treaty. He said he doesn't want to be part of a deal that other countries can take advantage of. Well, I agree. Other countries should not be able to take advantage of it. So what our plan includes is a border carbon adjustments. Now that sounds technical, but I'm going to break it down to you in very simple terms. Suppose that country A puts in place our plan, which is a carbon dividend plan, and we add border carbon adjustments, meaning a tax on any import based on its carbon content if it comes from a country that has a lower carbon price. Okay, so that's country A. Then country B does not have a carbon dividends plan or an equivalent carbon price. When it exports its products to country A, its products are taxed at the border for their carbon content. That levels the playing field, that's fair enough. But here's where it gets really interesting, because the money raised at the border would increase the dividends going to the citizens of country A, who would therefore be very happy. But the citizens of country B would soon realize, wait a minute, this money should actually be going to them. And they would start pushing for a similar plan in their country. And what you get from this is a new climate domino effect, meaning that once that one major country or region starts adopting this plan, other countries would follow. And this plan could start anywhere. Our preference is for it to start in the United States, but it could also start in the United Kingdom or Germany or France or China and India. All we need is one country to lead the way, to put this ambitious plan in place and to start a new climate domino effect. The obvious question everybody's going to ask, is this politically feasible, especially now that President Trump has left the Paris Agreement? Well, we think it is, and the proof is this. First, we started with the most prominent Republican elder statesman in the country endorsing our plan. Next, we got a number of the leading companies in the country endorsing our plan, including four of the world's leading oil majors, Exxon, BP, Shell, Total. Other companies ranging from General Motors to PepsiCo to Johnson & Johnson to Procter & Gamble have also signed on to this plan. But you know what? So have the Nature Conservancy and Conservation International, and so have political leaders, including Baker and Schultz, but also leaders like Michael Bloomberg, top economists like Larry Summers, top scientists like Stephen Hawking, all have signed on to this plan. The reason why we believe that this is the inevitable climate solution is because this is the plan where all core stakeholders in the debate can realize an important victory. And let me just summarize in a moment. For environmentalists, this is a much more effective climate solution that can get us much more emissions reductions. For conservatives, it offers a climate solution based on the principles of free market and limited government. It gives us a smaller government because we're reducing climate regulations and less emissions at the same time, a real win for Republicans. It's pro-business because it gives them a predictable environment, and it speaks to the strong desire among leading companies to have a proactive climate climate solution that gives them predictability. And it also speaks to voters because we're giving every American citizen a monthly dividend, which would add up to $2,000 a year for every family of four as of the first year. And here's the beauty of the plan. The more we protect the environment, the more everybody wins, because the higher the carbon tax rate, the less the pollution, the greater the dividend amount. You create a positive feedback loop where all key parties in the debate win. That's why we believe this is the inevitable climate solution. If you want to find out more, watch my TED Talk or go to our website of the Climate Leadership Council. You'll see the broad coalition that we've built, and you can learn a lot more about our carbon dividend solution.